Only 30 learners enrolled, the Department of Education last year resorted to shutting down Kheshwa Secondary School. The learners were then moved to Hilltown, where they claim their challenges began.
We're struggling to get food, and sometimes we go to school in hunger. Then we try several times to communicate with the principal and the government.
What did they say?
They promised us they're going to get food to us, for us. But that didn't happen.
We go to school with empty stomachs. But then our principal always tells us that we must go to school and we must focus on our education. It's not like we don't want to go to school. We do want to go to school. But the thing is, we don't have food in our hostel.
A provincial children's rights organization has stepped in.
And we have given them an ultimatum that by Wednesday, 17th of April 2019, all those learners must be taken back to a paid school where they would eat at home, sleep at home, and be provided with a scholar transport so that they wake up in the morning from their parents and they go to school and come back home, because there's no one who can survive while the stomach is empty.
The Department of Education presents a different case.
The allegations are absolutely not true. We've just spoken to the district director. She confirms indeed that the district itself put aside money, made sure that groceries were made for the learners. There is a matron at the school who makes sure that they are fed every day. Yes, indeed, it's true that towards the end of the year, last year, there were challenges because we could not award a service provider to make sure that they were fed. But we made sure that we forwarded that to you know, the service provider feeding Tumaletu. So that was taken care of. But as we speak, they are indeed being fed within the school.
The department is expected to meet with learners and their parents to forge a way forward. Yanga Funani, SABC News, Fort Beaufort.